Earth is really old. Estimates put the age of our Earth at 4.5 billion years. For 1.5 billion years, it was desolate. No life existed. But somewhere around 3.5 billion years ago, life began to sprout on planet Earth. Scientists know this based on fossilized bacteria found in Greenland that are around 3.7 billion years old. But what exactly makes our planet so special, where ours is the only one that we know of that allowed for life to form? Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, where did life come from? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe and let us know what you would like to see on this channel in the comments down below. Up until about 100 years ago, there was only one possible explanation for the origin of life on Earth, God. But since then, modern science has given us several theories on the origin of life. At this time, there is no one theory that's fully accepted among experts. Many scientists believe the Earth's oceans were once covered in ice. Remember, this was 3 billion years ago we're talking about. Our sun was only about a third as bright and powerful as it is now. That means our oceans were probably covered in a thick sheet of ice, hundreds of meters thick. At the same time, our atmosphere was still very young, which means that there was a lot of radiation from the sun hitting the surface of the planet. The thick layer of ice would have protected the organic molecules, allowing the key reactions to happen later on. Organic chemist Alexander Graham Cairns-Smith from the University of Glasgow suggested that life could have begun through clay. Clay contains material crystals which could have arranged organic molecules into organized patterns. As time went on, these molecules started to organize themselves. Then there's the idea that life began from a spark of electricity. Specifically, lightning. Back when our planet was still very young, its atmosphere was also very chaotic. It was filled with volcanic clouds that could have consisted of methane, ammonia, and hydrogen. It is a possibility that lightning from these clouds struck the surface of the Earth and that got the ball rolling. Amino acids and sugar can be generated from electricity. We know this thanks to the Miller-Urey experiment from 1953, where Stanley Miller and Harold Urey mimicked the primordial conditions on primitive Earth by exposing specific gases to an electrical charge. But at the time, the scientists didn't analyze the products of the hydrogen sulfide reaction. A few years later, a former student of Miller discovered the old bottled samples and found 23 amino acids and other organic molecules within them. Understanding how DNA formed is key to understanding how life formed. The reason why the origin of life is so hard to determine is that DNA needs proteins in order to form. But proteins actually need DNA in order to form. Scientists don't know how these two building blocks could have formed without the other. It's kind of like the did the chicken come first or did the egg come first paradox. But one explanation could be RNA. RNA is similar to DNA, but it's more often found in nature as a single strand folded onto itself. DNA is a double strand. Many scientists believe RNA was a lot more prevalent when the Earth was young and life was primitive. Cellular organisms as well as viruses use RNA to encode their genetic information. RNA stores information like DNA. It can create both DNA and proteins, and it serves as an enzyme. Later on, DNA, being more complex and more efficient than RNA, began to develop. But one thing that is uncertain is how RNA ended up on Earth at all. It either popped up spontaneously, which would mean life in the universe is incredibly rare, or it got here another way. And perhaps the most compelling theory of all is that life on Earth was actually brought here from somewhere else, like Mars. Mars gets hit by asteroids quite often, so much so that chunks of Mars have made their way to Earth. It is possible that organic microbes could have been brought to Earth from Mars, which would technically mean that all life on Earth is of Martian origin. Another prevalent but controversial theory is that life came to Earth by catching a ride on a comet from elsewhere in the galaxy. Maybe it was a combination of two or more of these theories. We just don't know because we can't go back in time 3 billion years. How do you think life began on planet Earth? Let us know in the comments below. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to go on an LBQ binge, check out our playlist Biggest What Ifs, clickable on the screen right now. And make sure notifications are turned on so you never miss a video. See ya!